Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is my spiritual night routine. You guys seem to really like my morning routine, so I'm doing my spiritual night routine, and it's gonna be as authentic as possible. There is nights that I do even more spiritual stuff in my like night, but I'm just gonna be really authentic to what I do most often, like my everyday type of spiritual night routine. And then if you guys are interested, I will also do my like more like extra type of spiritual night routine when I'm doing lots of extra spiritual things in my night. But without further ado, let's hop right into this night routine starting now. Clothes, which I absolutely need to do every time I get home because I love being in comfortable clothes. I then like to wash my face and get all the makeup off because it's so much more comfortable to not have makeup on. So I put my hair up and then I wash my face with the Soy Face Cleanser by Fresh. I absolutely love this stuff. It gets off my makeup so well and it leaves no residue on your face. This is not sponsored, by the way. I just genuinely really love this stuff. That's probably my 15th bottle of it by now, but yeah, let's get into that part and then we'll continue from there. And then right after I'm done washing my face, I always put on apple cider vinegar as a toner, and then I moisturize with the Tarte Drink of H2O Face Moisturizer. I really love this stuff. If you guys watch my morning routine, I go a little bit more in depth on my skincare routine, so if you guys wanna check that out, you can, but I didn't wanna film it twice in this, so basically I just did all of those things, and now let's hop into the rest of the stuff, because right after this, I love to light up my house with candles. Like I basically light up every candle I have in my entire house because I like those relaxing vibes and I make a cup of tea. So let's get into that part. Candles are lit and all of that jazz, and I have my tea made. I absolutely love to turn on my speaker, my Bluetooth speaker, and just listen to jazz vibes on Spotify. There's this playlist called Jazz Vibes, and it is so good, so relaxing. It puts me in the best mood ever. And then I also really love to read. I read basically every night, or I watch Gaia. Gaia is pretty awesome. By the way, this video is totally not sponsored, I promise. I actually personally just really love Gaia. And I really like to read, so the current books that I've been reading, because you guys ask this all the time and ignore all that camera equipment. We're filming a night routine tonight. This is just authentic, although usually all that stuff isn't usually right there. But currently I'm reading Plato, The Complete Works, because I really, really love philosophy. And I'm also reading Aristotle, Metaphysics. I know it sounds like I'm reading a lot of books at once, because I actually genuinely do that. It just depends what I feel like reading that night. I'm also reading The Secret History of the World. This book is so fascinating and interesting to me. I absolutely love it. But those are the current ones that I've been reading. Those three I kind of like have been swifting through every single night, just depending on which one I feel like reading. And I just sit there with my tea, listen to my jazz vibes. I really like listening to that while I'm reading, just because the fact that there's no lyrics in the background, because whenever I have lyrics in the background of songs, I can't focus. So jazz makes me focus, then I drink my tea. It's relaxing. Occasionally I'll also take a bath as well with Epsom salts, because Epsom salts also clear out like any energies of your day, and they help kind of just rinse all that kind of stuff away. Or I'll go read by the jacuzzi as well. It all just depends. A lot of the times though, I just read in my bed over there, and I have all my little selenite salt lamps lit. It's really beautiful, really cozy. I like to feel cozy with my tea, with my lavender tea tonight. Sometimes I also drink chamomile. It all just depends. And yeah, but the Epsom salt baths, in case you guys are wondering, if you ever feel like you've encountered like weird negative energy that day, you can literally run yourself a bath, put a bunch of Epsom salts or just salt in general, and it actually clears away and rinses out and takes away that negative energy. So, and it just like re-cleanses you, puts you back to your normal state. So in case any of you want to know how to get some good energy back, that's a really good quick way. I also like using sage and Palo Santo are also really good when you light them up and let the smoke kind of clear your energetic field as well. So around the time where I start getting pretty sleepy, I will usually then start to diffuse some lavender oil in my diffuser that I have over there, because this just gets me extra relaxed. Lavender is really good at calming your mind so that you're able to fall asleep quicker. I'm someone who, I have such a hard time falling asleep. Usually it'll take me like at least a half an hour to an hour to fall asleep once I close my eyes. And that's pretty frustrating to me. But ever since diffusing lavender oil before I actually go to bed, it relaxes my muscles a lot, calms my mind, because that's what lavender naturally does. It helps me fall asleep so much quicker than I normally would. So I'll do that usually about a half an hour before going actually in bed to fall asleep. And I also have a bunch of crystals by my bedside right in here. And sometimes, you know, a little bit before I go to bed, if I'm feeling something energetically that I want to change or shift, I will place some different crystals on my body before actually going to sleep. And sometimes I choose different ones to sleep with under my pillow, depending on what I'm trying to manifest. Or for example, like the crystal scolasite, I usually always place that one under my pillow because it also helps with insomnia and helps you fall asleep so much faster. And ever since I started placing scolasite underneath my pillow, I fall asleep so much easier. So I have a bunch of crystals beside my bed that help with certain things. I'll also use some for under my pillow or on my body. I don't ever fall asleep with the ones on my body though, because sometimes I've woken up and they're all of a sudden like under my back and I have this imprint, and all of a sudden I have this like sore back because I was sleeping on one of my crystals. Don't recommend, guys. But yeah, I'll generally place some of those on my body if need be. I don't ever really meditate at night. I usually wait till the morning to meditate, but the closest thing that I do during nighttime in a meditative fashion is to place crystals on my body before I fall asleep and kind of just allow my body to soak up those energies, all that kind of stuff, while smelling all those good lavender essential oils and drinking lavender tea. Sometimes it's chamomile though, but that's what I generally do, and then I go to bed. And that is all the things that I do in my night routine. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give me a really big thumbs up. Also comment down below what you guys do in your night routine. I'd love to know what you guys do, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.